Hey YouTubers, this is Lonnie Clark again. That's for art. I'm out here on the Willamette River again, walking down by the river path. This time you can see I'm like taking the back road. See up there, that's where the path is, but I'm down here. Anyways, I wanted to put this video up really quick and talk about something that I know is not being talked about. I talked to Kevin about it this morning, and I hope he incorporates this idea in his discussions on YouTube. You know how I have that poster that says, when scientists lie, people die? I get a lot of positive feedback from that, and people really like it. But what is also not being said in that is, when scientists lie, there is no science. If you withhold the last vital 10% of the information that needs to be told, and you create a scientific conclusion that is not based on the science that you actually gathered on the data, like Catherine Higley did with there's just as much radiation in a banana as there is in Fukushima. That is not science. When scientists lie, that is not science. So right now we have a scientific community being coerced and co-opted for money because, you know, people who feel like they need to have this money, they deserve to be well paid. So, you know, what was it, Tamplin and Goffman in that book, Population Control Through Nuclear Pollution? Arthur Tamplin went to a symposium, I think it was in Minnesota or something like that, and they didn't like his conclusions that the nuclear was really harming children. It was extremely detrimental to children, and that we probably should not build nuclear reactors, and it's not very good for us, and we don't know what to do with the waste. And at the symposium, this was at a university, and they basically said, if you don't take that out, we won't print your scientific study, we won't pay for you here, and we won't fund you to come here. They didn't tell him he couldn't come. They just said, oh, well, we're not going to pay for you to come, and we're not going to pay for your scientific study, which is expensive. Those things are quite expensive. And so, what did he do? He took it out. And he went to the symposium with the thinking that, you know what, it's better at least to get some of the information out. That's bullshit. You know, when you turn on a light bulb, if you only stop at 80%, the fucking light's never going to come on. Our energy to turn on something and to switch on the energy, it takes 80, 90% to turn the light bulb on. So that's where we're at right now, folks, in the Fuku fight. You know, in the nuclear truther movement. We're still pushing up, trying to get to that 58, past even 50%. I don't think we're even at the 50% of the energy level we're going to need. But when it goes up to 90, let's cross our fingers and hope that San Onofre or Diablo Canyon or some other nuclear power plant in America doesn't force America to go up to that 90% in one day. But we're still working it. And, you know, I've had a lot of hard talks with myself about why the heck am I doing this? Well, you know why? Because I love my family, and I love our humans, and I love the animals. I have a big heart. I love being alive. I love being a human being. I love the fact that I can think and learn and grow. And I'm 60 years old. I'm going to turn 60 in October. And I'm still growing. I'm going to school. My business, I'm actually still learning stuff in my business after 18 years, as sick as I am of it. But, you know, I guess I'm not that sick of it because I keep doing it. You know, I'm not willing to go get a job at the grocery store. So I'm just, but you know, the bottom line is this whole thing. When scientists lie, people die. When scientists lie, it's not science. It's not science. So I'm going to get some bumper stickers made up on that, I think. I really believe that I'm going to. And I hope other people will incorporate this idea into their videos and we can get this conversation out. I am going to be emailing Mike Papantonio and Sam Cedar, the progressive lefts, you know, and they're out in Florida. And I don't know why they have not been reporting on the elements of what's going on in Fukushima, but it's dangerous. And I want to stir that pot. I hope other people will join me so that we have, like, lots of people emailing the ringoffireradio.com. You can email them. And, you know, contact them and say, you know what, we want real science. We want you to find real scientists. And we need you to start defending the people of the earth. Because Papantonio's law firm defends people against Big Pharma. I mean, they keep themselves quite busy and quite rich from it. And nobody goes after the nuclear because of the Price-Anderson Act. But that does not mean that gives them a free pass not to talk about it. And not to know about it. And not to understand it. I mean, they have a venue that reaches out to millions of people. So I want us to start reaching out to them. So anyways, you guys, ciao. I'm glad that the sun's coming out. And You know, we're going to move it. We're still pushing up. We need to get to that 90% to where the light switch flips on, you know. Takes up 80, 90% of our energy. At that last 10 to 20%, that's when the light bulb comes on. And we're still pushing. So let's keep going. And ciao. Put your courage feet on.